had partial overdenture that was connecting to this bridge. You don't have anything in the middle. Always taking some kind of risk.
Hi, and welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Don't forget to like, share, follow, and subscribe to stay tuned up to date. With us today, as always, is Dr. Anil. Hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Amazing. How are you?
Great.
What did you bring for us today?
Well, today I want to discuss a little bit about when we want to use immediate loading and when we can overcome the usage of immediate loading and still have some teeth for the patient to be with. Because in many cases, we don't want to have immediate loading because there are some chances for complications with the implants or chances that the healing process won't be as good as if we wouldn't immediately load. So what we have here is we have a patient. The patient, before even the implantations, he had a bridge on two teeth. He had two canines. And he had the frontal bridge. On the posterior part, he had partial overdenture that was connecting to this bridge. So you have two canines, small bridge, and partial denture. He didn't use the partial denture, and he didn't have any use for the denture. So what we did is, we took both of the canines, we made a new temporary bridge because the old bridge was a little bit problematic for the implantations, and we placed some implants. Now, in this case, we want to wait until the implants are osseo-integrated, and then what we can do is we can remove this bridge, extract those teeth, we can add in the frontal area one or two implants, and make another temporary bridge on those on the posterior implants. In this way, you don't need to mount any implants that are not osseo-integrated.
You said this bridge resting on the canines while the implants are getting osseo-integrated.
Yeah.
Are any final bridges also made for resting on any teeth? Or what are the benefits of making a bridge rest on teeth and not implants? And why?
When the implant is not osseo-integrated, the problem with the mounting of the implant is that the implant is in the bone only because of the mechanical holdings, because of the pressure that the torque that you inserted the implant into the bone. About 2-3 weeks after the implantation process, the bone start to resorb, and remodeling of the bone is starting. So this is the most crucial part of the osseointegration. In here, you can't mount the implants. The fixation of the implant in the bone is most fragile. So either you can mount the implants right away, so you have immediate loading, or you can wait until you have full osseointegration. You don't have anything in the middle. In this case, if both of the canines, we were sure that you can make a bridge on those canines, maybe we will leave a permanent bridge on two canines and have on the implants from both sides two small bridges on implants.
When do you prefer not to do an immediate loading? Like, what are the, let's say, the guidelines for when you can do immediate loading and when it's probably won't be the best solution?
Immediate loading is always taking some kind of risk, because if you make an immediate loading, you're taking a risk that if you some kind of forces will be too strong on those implants, you will have a problem. And in this case, if we could place implants in the frontal area and on both sides and where the canines, there is a chance that we could make an immediate loading. But if we can overcome and we can place implants that will osseointegrate and we won't have any problem, I do prefer a full osseointegration. For example, for single tooth, almost always it's not good to make an immediate loading because the forces are very big on the singular implant. If you have a full arch, you have cases when you can immediate load, but the only advantage in immediate loading is the immediate aesthetics that you have for this patient. So if you don't have an aesthetical problem and the patient have some kind of bridge and you can make implants, make the implantations and wait for the osseointegration, it's always better. Because why you immediately load? Only because you want to have immediate good aesthetic or something like this.
So if you don't want good aesthetics?
If you don't have any aesthetical problem or you don't have any aesthetical requirements, because if the patient is going with two canines and a small bridge for a couple of years, another 3 months won't be an issue.
And if the patient has health issues or is older, so it's better to wait for a complete osseointegration.
Not older, but the diseases that come with the age.
I'm 30, it's pretty old.
It's pretty old.
I prefer to wait.
32?
32, yeah, I prefer to wait.
It's like 2% bigger than 30.
Okay, so next.
Now we had the osseointegration. And what we want to do now, now we can take impressions on those implants that were osseointegrated. And at the same time, we can extract both of the canines and add an implant or two in the frontal area. And this way, there is no one moment that the patient goes without teeth. In a week, we'll take out the stitches. We maybe take out the bridge and then return back the bridge to make sure that everything's fine. But there is no anesthetical problem. At first, the patient, as he was before, for a couple of months, he was with the bridge, the same bridge that he had before. Then we just load the implants, all of the implants, place another implant or two, extract the canines that wouldn't allow us to make to mount the bridge.
So the frontal part is not supported on any implants?
Yeah, right now no, because we want to wait for the osseointegration. Even though, you know, we already have most of the support from the posterior implants. So now we can mount on the anterior implants also. It's not a problem, in my opinion.
Or just an idea, can you make if you say you have enough support, so in the future you can make a stopper in the frontal area?
You can, but it's always better to have some kind of attachment if you have the place. You want to screw the bridge. You don't want the bridge to have any possibility to move in the frontal areas. So in this case, you can immediately load the two implants in the frontal area while the posterior implants are already osseointegrated.
So stopper is something that you do best not to do in the frontal area?
It's best not to do if you can avoid it.
If you can avoid it.
No, it is what it is. The biggest benefit that we had is we always had some kind of aesthetical solution, and we took the minimal risk for this patient in all of the restoration process. So you always have some kind of aesthetical solution and you minimize the risk for some kind of failure in the implantation.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, follow us to stay tuned with the latest cases. See you next time and have a great day.